Are you thinking about using the calculation power of Excel in your web application? Chances are that you are looking at using Microsoft Excel REST API to achieve that. But that's not the only option you have. Indeed, our solution AlchemyJ may even better suit your needs. In this video, I will do a comparison of these two solutions. At the end of the video, you can decide which one can solve your problem better. So I hope you'll stay until the end. Hi everyone, my name is Benson and I'm with AlchemyJ. With AlchemyJ, you can turn business models in Excel into APIs. We share tips about using Excel and AlchemyJ to build Excel applications and APIs. So don't forget to like and share this video and subscribe to this channel so you know when there is new content. When people first hear about AlchemyJ, I often receive comments like, "Isn't that what Excel REST API does?" Or, "How is it different from Excel REST API?" In today's video, I will do a comparison of Excel REST API and AlchemyJ. While they may do similar things to a certain extent, they are designed differently for good reason. First of all, what is Excel REST API? Microsoft sometimes refers it as Microsoft Graph Excel API, so I use these two names interchangeably in this video. By this name, you can tell that it is part of Microsoft Graph, which, referring to Microsoft website, is the gateway to data and intelligence in Microsoft 365. It exposes REST APIs to access data on Microsoft cloud services, including Excel Online. In short, it is a set of REST APIs that allows you to access your Excel workbook on Microsoft cloud. What about AlchemyJ? If you visit our website, you'll see that it says AlchemyJ converts Excel into APIs and Java programs. What it means is that AlchemyJ focuses on using Excel to build APIs so that web applications and Java applications can leverage the calculation power and modeling power of Excel. So what they have in common is that both provide REST APIs for accessing an Excel workbook. In the rest of the video, we'll see how they differ from one another in terms of accessibility, API structure, data persistence, permission, and functionality. As we mentioned earlier, Microsoft Graph Excel API is part of Microsoft Graph, which is hosted on Microsoft Cloud at graph.microsoft.com. You can access your workbook at this URL. Your Excel workbook can be stored in OneDrive for Business or SharePoint Online. That means this solution is completely hosted on the cloud. The API is on the cloud, and your workbook has to be on the cloud. In contrast to this, AlchemyJ converts an Excel workbook into a REST Java project. It can be a runnable jar with an embedded web server so that you can test the API very quickly, or it can be a WAR file that you can deploy it to a J2EE application server. That means you can test it locally, you can host it on-premise using your own infrastructure, or host it on the cloud if you wish. The API structure of these two products certainly shows that they are designed for different purposes. The API structure of Excel REST API is defined by Microsoft. It gives access to a set of Excel objects such as workbook, table, range, and named item. The caller has direct access to the workbook. It gives the caller freedom to read and manipulate any cells in the workbook. In other words, the caller needs to know the content in the workbook before using it. For example, if the workbook contains a list of records, to retrieve those records, the caller needs to know the range address or the table name. In AlchemyJ, things are very different. The person who creates the workbook adds additional definition to tell AlchemyJ what the API structure should be. You can define the URL structure including resource and query string parameters. You can define the HTTP methods to use, or even the header that the API should require or return. The caller, on the other hand, does not know the API is implemented using Excel. The caller uses the API according to the OpenAPI specification of the API. T take the BMI calculator we created in a previous video as an example. The workbook contains formulas that calculate BMI based on weight and height. When we define the API structure, we defined a resource called BMI. When it is called using a get method, it looks for the weight and height parameter in the query string and put those values into the designated cells C4 and C5, which are the weight and height values expected on the BMI worksheet. The caller can call this API using an URL like this. So the caller does not need to know anything about the workbook. In fact, they can't even tell the API is implemented using an Excel workbook, which could be a good thing. Let's see how these two solutions store data. As Excel REST API gives you the ability to manipulate all kinds of elements in an Excel workbook, it also provides three persistent modes. With persistent session mode, all changes made to the workbook are saved, meaning that you can actually use Excel like a database which can store things. If you create a new record in the table, it is still there the next time you open it or any other person opens it. With non-persistent session mode, changes are gone when the session ends. With sessionless mode, no changes to the workbook are saved. As for AlchemyJ, since it uses Excel as a calculation engine, an API call will not save any data in the workbook. In fact, after the API has been generated from a workbook, the workbook is not needed anymore. It does not even exist on the server, because all formulas in the workbook have been converted to Java code already. If the API needs to store data, you can use AlchemyJ extended functions to store data in a database or a text file. Here are the database functions that AlchemyJ provides for managing data in a database. You can use these functions when you write formulas in your workbook. For example, an API can receive a list of records and then use ajdbcreateRecord to insert those records into an Oracle database. The current version of AlchemyJ version 4.1 supports Microsoft SQL, Oracle, MySQL, and PostgreSQL. So, typically a web application that uses AlchemyJ would have a three-tier architecture where the presentation layer is written by React.js or other UI technology. The business layer is an AlchemyJ API that handles business logic as well as access control. And then there is a data tier that uses a database. As for permission, Microsoft Graph Excel API treats Excel workbooks as files. In fact, it is under the Drive API. It manages permission at the file level. There are two permissions. For reading a workbook, it requires files.read. For reading and writing or changing things in a workbook, it requires files.read/write permission. In contrast, AlchemyJ uses role-based security and controls access at resource and operation level. That is, you can define which role a user must have in order to access which resource using which HTTP method. This gives developers more detailed control, in my opinion, since you can publish an API that has many different resources and people with different roles can access different resources according to the role they have. Both solutions offer many functions. Here I just name a few things that one solution offers but the other one does not. First, Excel REST API allows you to modify a workbook and save the change on the server. You can do things like adding a new worksheet and changing a formula in a cell. Also, you can work on charts in your workbook. You can add, update, and delete charts, and you can get a chart as an image. For AlchemyJ, the purpose is to use Excel calculation power to build APIs. So it provides many extended functions for building APIs. These extended functions are functions that you can use in your Excel formula. You can work on big number and big string in your workbook. You can read and manage data in a database. You can read and write to a text file in an Excel workbook. You can process JSON data, retrieve information from an LDAP server, do data validation, send email, and many more. So if you are using Excel to build an API or an application, these functions can really help you do powerful things in Excel. Another cool thing about AlchemyJ is that it automatically generates open API specifications for your API. Developers can use this Swagger website to see what your API offers and try them out. In conclusion, Microsoft Graph Excel API lets you access your Excel workbook on Microsoft 365 Cloud via a REST API. It is a generic API that allows you to do almost anything on a workbook. If you want the API users to work directly on your workbook and modify your workbook, Excel REST API is a good choice. On the other hand, AlchemyJ turns a business model in Excel to a REST API that fits your needs specifically. The API users will not need to care about how you do things in the workbook, because they don't even know the API is implemented using Excel. If you want your calculation model in Excel to be accessible by other systems via REST API or Java class, AlchemyJ can help you do a better job. That's my sharing for today. If you want to know more about AlchemyJ, you can download a free copy at alchemyj.io and try it out. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and leave us your comments and questions below. I shall see you soon in the next video. Bye.